What's going on? Welcome back. It's about that time of year already. It's time to see what's really coming in 2022. And trust me, there's a lot coming. Make sure to subscribe and check out all the amazing channel members. Now let's get into this. So guys, the first game for today, and you guys can actually see it's the game I'm in right now. It's actually Envisioned Webverse, which is going to be one of the best Spider-Man games to ever come to Roblox. Now before I tell you guys anything more, just watch this trailer real quick and you guys will get a better understanding for how amazing this is going to be. And yeah, you guys can see this is gonna be a top tier Spider-Man game. It's gonna change the stereotype for Roblox Spider-Man games. This is gonna be the best of the best. And you guys started to see the swing in this testing, which I'll link all these games in the description, by the way. It's just amazing. I mean, here's some pictures of the cities you guys can see. And I mean, I don't know anything about this release date yet. All they have said is that's gonna be coming soon. So whatever that means, probably early 2022, we can expect this game to be dropping. So if you guys are a Spider-Man fan, get hyped for Envisioned Webverse revamp, because this is going to be amazing. Now again, I'll link Envisioned web testing in the description, but there is a game pass you can buy to actually get villains, and you can test out the symbiotes that are most likely going to be added to the revamp. We got Venom, Carnage, Riot, Anti-Venom, Old Suit Carnage, for example. They're all really good. I think, I don't know how he's going to change them, if he's going to change them, but you guys can see the transformations are great. They're a little bit small right now, but I'm pretty sure he's going to make them much bigger, much more powerful, because right now all I can do is jump, so they're going to have to do a lot more with that, but that's just something to keep in mind if you guys do want to test it out for yourself and spend the Robux on getting these guys. And now after I checked, they are actually 400 Robux, so if you want to do it, test them out. There's four symbiotes you can. There's Anti-Venom, Carnage, and then Normal Venom, and then I think that's it. There might be one more. Oh, and then Riot, of course. So all these symbiotes are going to be in the game most likely, and they're all super sick, and they're gonna be really fun to play with. I don't know if they're gonna be role playing or there's actually a goal to use with them. We're gonna have to see when the game drops early 2022, but I cannot wait for that. Now moving away from Marvel to DC, and there's gonna be plenty more Marvel in this video, do not worry. The next game we're gonna be going over is Gate Productions DC Universe Reborn. Now this is gonna be an open world Lego type of game with a mix of like DC Universe Online. It's gonna be very free roam, but with the ability to unlock pretty much every single DC known character in their universe, from Dr. Fate to Joker to Brainiac to literally any DC hero you want. Doesn't really matter how small they are, like they're just probably gonna be in the game. You name it, it's probably there, unless they're like a very, very unknown character. There's gonna be different lanterns, different planets you can go to. You guys got to see some clips from my last stream up here when I actually got early access to the game, and it looks so, so good. You guys can see some lanterns up here, and there's just so much to go over with this game. The only thing that we really have seen is just like inside and flying through space, because there's gonna be like a Justice League tower in this, as you guys could see, and just really so much in this game to go over, but really just a little gameplay, just a lot of really cool design stuff. Again, we haven't seen how fun this game is actually going to be yet, but we do know it's going to be dropping early to mid 2022, probably. I'm guessing like January to February is when they're going to be dropping this game, because they have been working on it for a month and there is so much for them to go over. And the amount of characters and maps they're going to have in this, I think it's like 32 plus different maps they're going to be having. It's just insane. And you guys can see, I mean, just look at the detail on the planets I have here. It's just honestly so good, and I cannot wait for this game. Heroes Unlimited is a game coming late 2021 to early 2022, and is going to be probably the best DC slash Marvel game on Roblox, with so many capabilities in this game, and it's going to be very similar to one of the hit Roblox superhero games, Age of Heroes. You're going to be able to customize your character, as you guys can see here, from varieties of hairs and suits and colors. Everything is going to be customizable. It is going to be insane. You can make any hero you want and choose the abilities you want for it, whether it's going to be Iron Man, it's going to be Kryptonian, Speedster, Shazams, Firestorms, Lanterns, and there's going to be three different classes from what we know so far. So Kryptonians and like Speedsters would be in the meta class, similar to how DC Universe Online does it, and then like there'd be like a magic for like Shazams and other heroes, and then Lanterns and Iron Man, when they get added, it's going to be like a tech class, maybe even Blue Beetle. So there's some really cool things that are going to be added to this game. Once you choose what you want though, so let's say I want to be a Speedster, you guys can see you get those abilities, and I mean they're great. You guys can see they look very awesome, and you guys are actually going to be able to test out these abilities 2 with the testing server that we're going to be heading over to in a second. And along with having great customizability, there's actually going to be the ability to fly to space and go to different planets. It's one of the best flying systems I have ever seen. So you guys can see the map is massive already, and this is how fast you're going to be able to fly on a normal map, which is a great flying speed for a map at this size. But once you fly up enough, you're actually going to be able to enter orbit into space, and you guys can see the space is looking great. There are going to be multiple planets that you're going to be able to fly to and level up, kill different thugs and villains, and get more levels and items and stuff like that. This game is going to have crazy potential, and it's going to have a very similar concept to Age of Heroes, and you guys can see here, it's already so amazing. And along with that, the abilities in this are top-notch. For just to give you an example of how well and how well detailed these are, if we go to water for a second as a speedster, and by the way, I'll link the testing server in the description so you guys can check out all the abilities for yourself, but if you go to water, you guys can see, look at the water when you run over it. There's actually a trail that follows behind you. I have never seen a game have water running like that, and it's just so beyond smooth, and then once you stop running, you fall into the water, and it's just like that. It's amazing. It's so good. And then for every hero that's going to be added that are not added in yet, you guys can see we're going to have an Iron Man Mark 85, which is going to be absolutely insane, and along with a Blue Beetle that will eventually be coming as well. We only have the mask for that, but that's going to be sick as long as we get a tech class, because I cannot wait to have like a full body Blue Beetle suit with customizable colors and stuff like that. It's just going to be so epic. And we recently just got a leak for Wanda Maximoff, who might be joining the game as well, so that's going to be really cool to see how he's going to implement that into the game, because Frost, who's developing this game, is a great developer, and I cannot wait to see how he makes her customizable and adds her to the game to make this the best Roblox superhero game ever. Now, what is known to be the heavy hitter, or what is going to be the heavy hitter of Roblox superhero games, and especially Roblox Marvel games for a while, is obviously Marvel Infinity, and we have talked a lot about this on the channel, and if you don't know what it is, it's going to be like a free roam, open world Marvel game with pretty much all the main characters from the MCU, no X-Men or anything like that just yet. And it's going to be insanely high quality from characters like Captain Marvel, as you guys can see here, actually fighting off the Hulk, which is just super sick. I mean, everything looks so smooth about that fight. Like, it's just such a well-made game, but then they're gonna have crazy maps like Thanos' farm to literally just the most high-tech Mark 85 we have ever seen on Roblox, which is the best modeler ever. We're gonna get planets like Titan, we're gonna get planets like Vormir. I mean, we're gonna get the big planets that we saw in the movie, and just some of the best parts about it. There's even gonna be super detailed maps like Tony Stark's mansion, and I mean extremely detailed, from Doctor Strange's lab all the way to WandaVision's hometown. There's just so much stuff that's gonna be in this, guys, and it's literally every MCU map you have ever seen is gonna be in this game. Literally any other Marvel character you can think of, it is going to be insane, and it's going to break a Roblox when it comes out, if it ever comes out. And it's looking to be coming out like around late 2022, maybe end of 2022. We really don't know too well yet. Now, for all you speedster fans out there, this is going to be the game for you. Now, it is already out, it is called Velocity Online, but they're having a huge revamp coming with so much to talk about. But first off, if you've not played Velocity Online, how it works is you don't actually have superpowers, but the way to increase your speed is to get better tech to run faster. So for example, I am kind of faster now. I can still run up walls, but I am not that fast. The new revamp is going to be where you have to get faster to even get lightning. Before now, what you can do to increase your speed is you can run around like this to gain cash. And what cash does is you can actually go to the shop in the game. And at the shop in the game, you can buy more suits. And the shop looks something like this right here. You just go up right here and you buy whatever you want to get higher level suits that can make you run faster, along with X composite. Now, what these suits do is, for example, if we go into my inventory and we click on one of these suits, like let's say we get like the best one in the game, the prototype, you click on that, and then let's say you want goggles, for example, you click on those, and then you press a V, and it comes on like that, and boom, you got your suit. It's like nanotech, and then you can change the color of it, and look how much faster I'm going now. You just color to try whatever you want to, along with other things you would actually inject yourself with or spend Robux on to get even faster. So like, for example, I can give myself X composite to go even faster than I'm going now, so I'll inject myself like this, and I'll get like a crazy speed boost, kind of like Velocity X in the show The Flash. But this has nothing to do with Marvel or DC. It's in its own realm of speedsters. I mean, just look how fast I'm going now. And then you can also spend extra Robux to get a Velocity Enhancer. For now, it's like 1,000 Robux, but you guys can see if you press T, you get this little thing right here, and then you press a B for a boost, and then boom, look at that. So you're going crazy fast, all just from these upgrades. No superpowers involved in this, and let me just show you guys what this is going to be like when the real game comes out, because it's going to be absurd. So what you guys can see up here is going to be the new running coming to Velocity Online, and the lightning will only be obtainable if you wear the suit that requires the high amount of energy output. So pretty much meaning you're going to need a higher level suit to be fast enough to get lightning or just run at the speed of light. You guys can also see like the speed here and just how nice it looks. So there's a lot coming with this. Now, this is kind of an extra game because I don't find it to be as significant yet to these other games coming out because it's not as far into development. So if you guys know the game Avengers Testing Server, it's pretty much an awesome game where you can test all the Avengers and Marvel characters, very well made top tier characters in my opinion. They're also getting a revamp similar to Webverse, but just not as many things adding to it. As far as I know, there's going to be new swinging, and I made a lot of videos on it. As you guys can see up here, it's looking awesome. It's going to be really fun and really fast, kind of a different type of Spider-Man style with a more realistic city. So I find this to be kind of an extra because there's not going to be anything new to the game. It's still going to be kind of just like a role-playing Spider-Man game, but I'll keep you guys posted if they ever add any more goals to it or stuff you can actually do in it besides just swinging. So with that said, that's all I know about this. So yeah, and since I went over so many games today, if you guys want to see me rank all of these games, go check out this video right here where I went over literally every single popular superhero game on Roblox and ranked them from worst to best for 50,000 subscriber special. So make sure to go check that out, and I'll see you guys later.